And it's embarrassed. Because if you look at the budget presentation, look at the debt service. The debt service is almost above capital. 3 point something trillion. Why I say it's embarrassing is for the first 16 or to 25 years back, Nigerian money are looted, keep it, some they put our money like dead bodies in the grave, they buried our money, some they carry our money abroad. Why can't the government make a strong interrogation and investigation team? Call back these people, investigate, bring back our money to implement the budget. We have to stop borrowing because we don't know tomorrow. Why, that is my worry. If you look at an example, an estimate, a woman, a single person, the former petroleum minister, he went with $60 billion. That is 5 years budget. 5 years Nigerian budget, her alone. And there is thousands of her. If there is real investigation, there is thousands like her. So when we investigate, we can spend 20 years, next 20 years, we will not borrow. We will implement budget with our recovered money. So seriously, this government said they are fighting corruption. They are fighting corruption. But I never see fighting corruption. Because we are going, we are saying we are fighting corruption, but we are going very slowly. Very slowly, and we are saying by mouth. But we are not acting practically. If there is strong investigation, strong interrogation team in this country, I am sure we will not borrow any money. Sadly, if you look at now, look at the issue of revenue. They say revenue formula is already gone down. Oil has already left up in many countries in the world. Oil has gone down. If we look at this country, before oil recovered in this country, we were implementing and running the government with the farming money. Money generated through cotton and groundnut. And we used that money to explore oil. We used that money to get the oil. Why we abandoned the farming? Look at our teeming youth going on employment. Look at our forest. Only criminals are living inside. Why can't we clear all this forest? Allocated to our teeming youth, funded them, go for farming. If we can do this across the seas, our geopolitical zone, I am sure we will get money better than oil, and we will fund it budget without borrowing. But the most embarrassed is debt service. Look at the debt service. Finally, what I assume is why I say we have to recover our stolen money. We are paying debt to the money which is being stolen. Our team in Nigerians never enjoys that money, and we are still paying debt. The money that we're supposed to complete our railways, our road, our education, our health, our security is going on debt. And this debt is in some individual pocket. Went to individual pocket. Go around this town, go around this country. Look at the type of mansion people are living in, a government officials, and they say they are fighting corruption. Go to Metama, go to Asokoro, go to Lagos, go to Port Harcourt. See people living in mansion, and they are government officials. Is their salary get that mansion for them? And we say we are fighting corruption. If we are really fighting corruption in this country, we will not borrow money to fund. It's embarrassed. I am worried. Even my blood pressure go high as I had the debt service. 3 point something trillion debt service. Why people are suffering in this country? Some are living with 1 square meal. They eat once. So if we can do a proper, strong anti-corruption, not this by mouth, by we act it practically. If you go, you can see a 1 billion mansion owned by a government official. And they say that we are fighting corruption. Salary of his 1,000 yen. Did he serve for 1,000 yen? He served for 35 years. Where did he get 1 billion mansion? If we are serious, you can see still person serving inside the government, owning a big house, billions, estate. You can see business places here, owned by government officials. And we say we are fighting corruption. We are joking. We are joking. So we are, it's embarrassed. So we have to educate our teaming people. We have to educate our people. We have to force the government. And I am advising to Mr. President to look at this, my advice. We have to go back to strong interrogation and investigation team that we will investigate and bring back our looted money to stop borrowing. To stop borrowing.
Thank you very much.
My name is Honorable Mohammed Gudaji Kazore, and also a speaker of the masses. That is my name. Representing Kazore, Roni, Gwiwa, and Enkwashi. I'm from Jigawa State. That is representing four local government, one of the largest constituents in the country.
Thank you very much, sir.